This is class 11 things, but it's useful every day in laboratories. So suppose I ask you, I have seen that I have asked question about what is the weight of water filled in 1 cubic meter of container. So several times you have heard that 1 cc means 1 ml. So, and density of water at room temperature, normal temperature, is 1 gram per ml. So if you can calculate number of ml of that container, then you can easily calculate grams of water, because density of water is 1 gram per ml. So you can easily calculate grams of water present in that container. And if you know grams of water, this is your question, Hana. So we can easily calculate number of mls of water present in that 1 cubic meter. 1 cubic meter means, if we can write it 100 centimeter into 100 centimeter into 100 centimeter, can we write dimension of this container as 100 centimeter into 100 centimeter? 1 meter into 1 meter into 1 meter is 1 cubic meter. So we can write 100 centimeter into 100 centimeter into 100 centimeter. That is same. So that means 10 to the power 6 cubic centimeter. And density of water is 1 gram per ml, means 10 to the power 6 gram. That means 10 to the power 3 kg. So your answer should be 1000 kg. Everybody is getting this?
So 10 to the power 6 ko humne kisse multiply kar hai?
10 to the power 6 gram hua na? Centimeter. Okay. 10 to the power 6 cubic centimeter, not centimeter, cubic centimeter.
हाँ जी.
And 1 cubic centimeter means 1 ml. Okay.
Yes sir.
So you have 10 to the power 6 ml water, and weight of 1 ml of water is 1 gram, because density of water is 1 gram per ml. So in 1 ml there is 1 gram.
Yes,
in
sir.
This way, in 10 to the power 6 ml equal to, we can say mass of that 10 to the power 6 ml water is 10 to the power 6 gram. 10 to the power 6 gram can also be written as 10 to the power 3 kg,
yes,
kilogram.
Sir. Yes, sir.
10 to the power 3 kg can also be written as 1000 kg or not?
Yes sir. Okay sir.
1000 kg tha option usme. Second, how many molecules are there in 1 cubic meter of any gas at NTP? Everybody will write in message. Write your answer in message. I request everybody to write. Anybody is calculating? So, how did you calculate Bhumika?
सर आई मल्टीप्लाईड इट इट विद 1.67 इनटू 10 टू द पावर माइनस 24
नो 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 जस्ट कैलकुलेट फॉरगेट मॉलिक्यूल जस्ट कैलकुलेट नंबर ऑफ मोल्स ऑफ गैस प्रेजेंट इन 1 क्यूबिक मीटर ऑफ कंटेनर एट एमटीपी नंबर ऑफ मोल्स कैलकुलेट First calculate number of moles. No wrong, Simant Kumar wrong. Can you calculate moles? Bhumika and Simant, try to calculate moles of gas present in 1 cubic meter of container. Calculate moles, then we will convert it into molecule. Yes. Himangi ya Mohit to pahle se wo kiya hua hai, isi liye mat bolo isme calculation mein. Himangi. But if someone will...
Okay sir, okay, okay.
Agar koi nahi dega tab dena. नहीं तो पूरा का पूरा ये तो खाली हो जाएगा बट
ओके सर
चलो अब एक्सप्लेन करो एक्सप्लेन इट मोहित और हिमांगी समवन शुड एक्सप्लेन बिकॉज आई हैव वेटेड फॉर अदर्स रिप्लाई हिमांगी
यस सर
एक्सप्लेन इट हाउ डिड यू कैलकुलेट
एट एसटीपी 22.4 लीटर इज इक्वल टू 1 एमएल तो वी
1 ml
सॉरी 1 लीटर 1 मोल 1 मोल 1 मोल 1 मोल सॉरी 1 मोल 1 मोल
यस
देन वी हैव 1 मीटर क्यूब इज इक्वल टू 1000 लीटर सो 1000 लीटर इज इक्वल टू हाउ मेनी मोल्स तो 1000 इनटू 1 डिवाइडेड बाय 22.4 सो इज इक्वल टू 44.64
मोहित
यस सर
ही इज राइट
यस सर ही इज राइट
सो सी दिस मोल कांसेप्ट That's why I showed you. One mole of as any gas occupies 22.4 liter of that gas at NTP. Or you can say 22.4 liter of gas at NTP equal to one mole of that gas.
Sir, number of moles into Avogadro number will give us number of molecules.
Yes.
Okay.
Now, can you count molecules of IgG in IgG solution having 50 microgram of IgG? So note down question. If you are not able to reply now, you should try it. You should check it. All these are simple questions, but frequently asked in competitive exam, and you will also use it. During your lab work. Calculate number of human genomic DNA in 100 nanogram human genomic DNA. Suppose you have isolated genomic DNA, human genomic DNA. So you have to calculate how many copies of human genome are present in that 100 nanogram. So if you can calculate weight of one genome, then you can easily calculate number of copies of that genome. You have already calculated. Here, Tana calculation.
Yes, sir.
Weight of one genome, then easily you can calculate number of copies of the genome. Fine. This is all answer of these things. You can note down. If you are facing any problem, then you can again discuss. Overall, for mole concept, if you are using this chart, you can easily calculate. So, if you know number of molecules, and if someone is asking you, tell me what is the weight of 100 molecules of water. So what you will do, so you will convert it into moles and then you will calculate it with its weight. Suppose you know weight, and if you wish to calculate volume, if it is gas, then from weight convert it to mole and then calculate its volume. In this way, you can go from one way to another way, but go calculate first mole, so it becomes easy for you to solve. Now, preparation of solution. How will you check your micropipette is working properly or not? So, if we take pure water, suppose we are aspirating 100 microliter. So, what would be the weight of 100 microliter of pure water? 0.1 gram. So, if you are taking water and weighing it with the help of weighing machine, if it is showing 0.1 gram means 100 milligram, that means your micropipette is working properly. It's easy to check proper functioning of your micropipette. In molecular biology, we don't use that glass pipette and other pipette. We mostly use micropipette. There is regular calibration in laboratories, but still you should check your micropipette. Don't rely on that tag, yes, this is calibrated. So don't rely on that only. Second question, why a stock solution is required? Why a stock solution is required? So that we can store it, and whenever we need, we can just dilute it. So it will save time. And second thing, it will also reduce the chances of error. Suppose we need 100 microgram antibiotics. It's difficult to weigh 100 microgram. So there is chances of error. So we prepare their stock solution. So chances of error will reduce. And we can store it for longer time. That's why we prepare a stock solution ready to use. Otherwise, every time we prepare, solubilize, we weigh that reagent solute, and then we solubilize it, then we maintain their pH, means we add other acid or base. So we adjust the pH and then autoclave it. It will take long time. So we make a stock solution so that whenever we need, we can dilute it and use it for our purpose. And from one stock, we can use for different purpose also. Sometimes we need different concentration. Sometimes we need some other concentration. So from a stock solution, we can use that. So now third question, why we prepare different reagents, a stock solution of different strength? Stock solution is good. Then why some stock solutions are two times, some are five times the stock, some are 50x. Why not all solution we prepare as a 50x? X means times. 50x means whatever working is, we store it as a 50 times more concentration, concentrated solution. We use 2x, suppose STS dye, SDS loading dye, we stock it as a 2x. In SDS space running dye, running buffer, we store it as a 5 times stock, 5x. DNA loading dye, bromophenol blue dye, we store it as a 6x. TBE buffer, TAE buffer, for DNA, this agrogel running buffer, we store it as a 50 times more concentrated. Always working solution is 1x, 1 times. So we prepare a stock as a multiple of that working. So working concentration is dependent on, or you can decide based on experiment. Experimentation will decide how much concentrated, how much molecules of that solution, how much molecule of reagent is required in that solution for running the gel or staining the gel or whatever. But for a stock solution, we can prepare in any concentration like 50x, but we prepare something as 2x. Why not the stock solution? Generally we prepare 2x, why not we keep it as a 50x? Which things, which factor decides that yes, this solution cannot be stored at 50x, or it's arbitrary? Something we can prepare 2x wala ko bhi hum 5x bana ke rakh sakte hain, 5x wale ko 10x bana ke rakh sakte hain. Those who have run that SDSP, they must have prepared that 5x trisglycine buffer, and those who have run that DNA, they must have prepared 50x TAE. Suppose in working solution we need 25 millimolar salt. So if we wish to prepare a stock solution of 50x, then 25 millimolar into 50, how much it is? It becomes 1200 millimolar. So whether that 1200 millimolar is soluble or not? If it's not soluble, then you have to prepare in less concentrated, because no stock solution we cannot. If suppose we are adding sugar in that water, if we keep on adding the sugar in the water, what will happen? After certain time, certain concentration, it becomes super saturated. You will get precipitate. So your stock solution will not remain homogeneous. In top you will get liquid, in bottom you will get that solid. So solution means from any corner, if we are taking that solution, so in that solution per ml number of molecules must be same. That is called homogeneous solution. So to prepare homogeneous solution, solubility is the factor. So we cannot prepare, suppose that bromophenol blue dye, we cannot prepare it as a 50x, because in that dye we add glycerol. So working glycerol concentration is 6%. So 6% into 50, how much? If we prepare 50x, so 6% into 50 is 300%. Can we add 300% of glycerol? The solubility of that reagent decides how much concentrated solution you should prepare, how much concentrated stock solution you should prepare. Now you calculate, you note down this question and calculate N1 V1 and N2 V2 using that formula. So here, what would be the volume? What would be the volume of that diluted solution? So 20 is already, you will add concentrated solution 4. So it becomes 24. So you must add in this way, N1 plus V1 equal to N2 plus N2 into 20 plus V1, and then calculate V1. Your V2 is volume of that diluted solution, DNA solution is 20 is already there, and you will add something from N1, from one stock solution. So your V2 is 20 plus V1. Then in this way we can calculate that V1. Then you should write X into 20 plus V1. Final should be 1X. You see my N1 V1 and 2 V2. So 6X into V1 equal to X into 20 plus V1. Now you have to calculate V1. So V1 will be 4 if you will calculate here in this way. You have to calculate V1, it would be 4 microliter. Here in this calculation, volume of that concentrated solution is additive. So we must consider that added volume of V1. Now next, you must remember all this formula if you wish to smoothly work in laboratories, either in MSc or PhD. All these formula you must remember. Now calculate this. How many grams of NaOH is required to prepare 100 ml NaOH solution of a strength 0.1 molar? Mole fraction, you all are knowing about mole fraction. If not, you don't know, you can see this. So mole fraction of A in mixtures of X, number of moles of A, Y, A and Y number of moles of B, Z number of moles of C. Means total number of moles of different solutes present in the mixture, that is total. So in that total, if we wish to find out the mole fraction of one, anything, A, so number of moles of A present in that mixture divided by total number of moles, that is mole fraction. So now calculate mole fraction of 2 molar ethanol solution. What is the mole fraction of ethanol in 2 molar ethanol solution considering that density of water in ethanol is same? Do you want any hint? This is 2 molar ethanol solution. In 2 molar ethanol solution, you have to calculate mole fraction of ethanol. So you have to calculate first total number of moles of both water and ethanol. So you know in 2 molar ethanol, how much grams of ethanol is present? So in 2 molar ethanol, your molecular weight of ethanol is 45. So 2 molar ethanol means 46 into 2 grams, means 92 grams of ethanol is present in 1000 ml of that solution. That means the remaining volume is occupied by water. Here we are considering that this density of ethanol and water is same. So we can consider 46 gram ethanol equal to 46 ml of ethanol. Means 92 ml of ethanol is present in 1000 ml. So how much water is present? So water is 1000 ml minus 92, means 908 ml of water is present in that solution. So number of moles of water is 908 divided by 18. So 50.4 moles of water is present. So total moles of reagent present in this mixture is 40.4 moles of water plus 2 moles of ethanol. This total number of moles present is 50.4 plus 2, means 52.4 moles are present in that mixture. So mole fraction of ethanol is equal to 2 by 52.4. And mole fraction of water, that is 1 minus mole fraction of ethanol, if you will calculate, you can find mole fraction of water. You can note this question and try to prepare. Try to reply it. Try to solve it yourself. You can note all these questions. These all questions are up to 10th class only. I'm quickly moving. This question also you can note and you can prepare. This is also based on N1 and B1. So this is final concentration. Here we are taking 100% means 1, 30% means 0.3. So we have already 10 ml 30%. So we are here adding, and we are taking X ml from 100%, so that we can prepare 0.4 means 40% of this. What is the volume, final volume? Again, like previous question, X ml if we will add from this 100%, so total volume will increase. So this is N2 V2. This is N2 means this is concentration of your final things, 40%. So this is 40% and this is the final volume. So initial volume is already 10 ml present. The volume will increase by addition of this 100 100% solution, saturated solution. So this is based on N1 V1 only. You can find it after calculating. You can find X is here, X volume. So you can find 1.66 ml is required to prepare 40% solution of ammonium sulfate from the saturated solution. If we have already 30% solution, here final volume is not important. We have added this. Sometimes we fix final volume, working solution volume. Here concentration is important. Concentration must be 40%. Fine. Good.
Yes, sir.
You can note down all these things and try to compose your own question and try to solve it. In this practice, you can improve yourself. Suppose this, like this question, you yourself can put arbitrarily 50% here, and then you can calculate how much volume is required, and then again reverse calculate whether your answer is right or not. From 40 to 50%, how much volume is required from saturated solution? Generally, we use this ammonium sulfate solution for precipitation of protein. Different cutoff we take, different concentration of this ammonium sulfate for precipitation of protein from the sample. So this is formula. You all are aware of all this formula. But again, for refreshment, please either note down or remember it so that you can do your exercise, laboratory exercise. This is an important question. This question, just try to reply, and I'm expecting answer from everybody. How much stock solution of ampicillin should be added in 100 ml LB broth if final concentration of ampicillin is 100 microgram per ml is required? Most of you have used that E. coli culture or other bacterial culture in which you are adding antibiotic so that other bacteria will not grow. Only your plasmid containing bacteria will grow. So for that, we prepare 100 milligram per ml stock solution of ampicillin, 50 milligram per ml stock solution of kanamycin. In this way, we prepare that stock solution. So suppose your culture volume is 100 ml, then how much concentrated antibiotic you should add in that so that final concentration of antibiotic should be 100 microgram per ml. So I'm expecting that there are 69 participants. I reply within 1 minute from all 69. Whatever you know, I'm giving you sufficient time, but write down your answer. How much hair means how much volume? In this question, how much stock solution means how much volume of stock solution of ampicillin should be added in 100 ml LB broth if final concentration of ampicillin is this much required. Can we write this C-? 100 milligram per ml into V, volume which is required, equal to 100 microgram per ml into 100 ml. So if we convert this 100 milligram into micrograms, what will happen? 100 into 1000 microgram per ml. So your stock solution is 100 into 1000 microgram per ml. Now you can easily calculate it that your stock solution have 100 into 1000 microgram per ml into V1 equal to 100 microgram per ml into 100. So if final will be 0.1 ml, final answer will be 0.1 ml. 0.1 ml means 100 microliter. So this type of things, this is frequently used by researchers in MSc, MBA, PhD. In this type of question, if we will hesitate to reply, if we are not able to reply within minute, then we must think, we must give more time to improve our standard. Fine. So 100 microliter is right answer. So you have to prepare 70% ethanol. You add 70 ml absolute ethanol, and in same container you have added 40 ml water by mistake. Usually for preparation of 70% ethanol, if we prepare 100 ml, then we add 70 ml 100% ethanol plus 30 ml water. So by mistake we have added 40 ml. What we should do? Whether we should throw it, or we should work with that solution only, or we should do something else? We should throw it and prepare again, or we should work with that already because this is minor differences. Iske badle 40 par gaya, thoda sa antar hua, can we work with that, or we should do something else? Yes. So how much ethanol you will add so that concentration remain as per your wish, 70%. We have added 10 ml extra water. So 30% is 10 ml. So 1% is 10 by 30 ml. And you have to add 70%. You have to make it 70%. So 70% is 10 into 70 divided by 30. So 23.3 ml. If you are adding 23.3 ml of water, of ethanol, then concentration remains 70%. Concentration will not change. Only volume, final volume increase, but concentration remains change. You don't have to throw your solution, ethanol. Fine? And you don't think that if you will consume, so it is utilized. You don't consume also. Now, why cell divides? If we ask you mathematical answer or from physics point of view, cell divides to maintain surface area to volume ratio. Means if it will increase, cell will increase, so per unit volume, surface area will decrease. If surface area will decrease, then cell cannot communicate with environment. Environment may be of other cells or maybe from environment. So it cannot exchange sufficient material, other oxygen or other material. It cannot communicate with environment. If per unit surface area will reduce. Suppose your room is very big and there is only one window, then there is very less exchange of air and other things. Or suppose if there is only one gate in very big room, then you cannot go and many people cannot go inside and come outside easily. So to maintain this surface area versus volume ratio cell divides. No, if it don't divide, it will burst. So that is means they cannot communicate, they cannot exchange material from outside. That is main purpose. So surface area, if you can see like this example. See, if radius 1 mm, then what is the ratio? Surface area versus volume ratio is 3. If it is an again increasing, then you can see surface area versus volume ratio is decreasing. If it will again increase, so this ratio is decreasing. In this way, if it will increase, volume will increase, surface area will not increase in that proportion, that factor. So surface area versus volume ratio will decrease. So surface, if surface area will decrease, they will not maintain exchange with environment. The scope of exchange of nutrition or exchange of oxygen will decrease. So if you can go in reverse way, if it divides, so 3 mm cell becomes 1.5 mm radius. So again, this becomes 2 ratio. In this way, if it divides,